Microbial identification is the process of determining the specific type or species of bacteria and fungi. This is a fundamental aspect of microbiology and is essential for various fields, including pharmaceuticals. There are two methods for microbial identification: phenotypic and genotypic methods. Phenotypic methods include the microbial identification based on their morphological characteristics, such as shape, size, color, arrangement under a microscope, Gram staining, and biochemical tests. The phenotypic characteristics of microbes may alter under certain conditions. For example, color of a microbial colony may appear different on two different media. However, the microbial response to certain biochemical reactions is specific. Based on this, several developments have been made in the recent years to bring consistency in these biochemical identification systems. Unlike the phenotypic methods, the genotypic techniques are based on the microbial genome. Genotypic techniques do not depend upon the isolation medium or growth characteristics of the microorganisms. This technique involves sequencing of 16S rRNA to identify the microbes. Out of these two methods, phenotypic identification methods are widely used in the industry, as they are more cost-effective. The traditional identification methods are labor-intensive and time-consuming. The advent of automated microbial identification systems has transformed the way we approach this critical aspect of microbiological research and practice. Automated microbial identification systems have brought advanced data analysis techniques to identify microorganisms rapidly and accurately. These systems have emerged as vital tools for laboratory technicians. By streamlining the identification process, they not only save time and resources, but also enhance the precision and reproducibility of results. The most widely used automated microbial identification systems in the pharmaceutical industry are Vitek 2 Compact and Vitek MS. Let us discuss how these two instruments work. Vitek 2 Compact is the best for industrial microbiology testing environment. It features 21 CFR Part 11 compliance and advanced colorimetry technology. The instrument utilizes reagent cards that have 64 wells. Each well contains individual test substrate. These substrates measure various metabolic activities like acidification, alkalinization, enzyme hydrolysis, and growth in the presence of inhibitory substances. The card is sealed with transparent film on both sides, which minimizes aerosols, splattering, spills, and personal contamination. Each card is integrated with a transfer tube for the transfer of microbial culture to the card. Each card has a barcode that contains information like lot number, expiry date, and a unique identification number that can be linked to the sample. There are six types of cards available for the identification of different microorganisms. GN card for the identification of gram-negative organisms. GP card for gram-positive cocci and non-spore-forming bacilli. BCL card for spore-forming bacilli. YST card for yeasts. NH card for Neisseria, Haemophilus, and other fastidious gram-negative bacteria. ANC card for anaerobic bacteria. Isolate the microorganism using streak plate technique on appropriate media. Ensure that the culture is pure. If the culture is not pure, perform one more subculturing to get a pure culture. Perform a Gram staining from an isolated colony and document the Gram staining details. As mentioned earlier, select an appropriate card based on the Gram stain reaction and microscopic observation of the culture. Take a polystyrene test tube and aseptically transfer 3 milliliters of sterile saline. Prepare a homogeneous suspension using isolated colonies of test microorganism with the help of a sterile cotton swab or inoculation loop. Adjust the density of the suspension using the density check meter based on the card chosen for the microorganism. Ensure that the density check is calibrated using standards. Once the desired density is achieved, the suspension needs to be transferred into the identification cards. In order to transfer the suspension into the cards, the polystyrene tube containing the culture suspension will be placed into a special cassette. And the identification card is placed in the adjacent slot, such that the transfer tube goes into the corresponding suspension tube, as shown in this picture. The cassette can accommodate 10 cards at a time. Place the cassette into the filling station, a Vitek 2 compact. The instrument will automatically transfer the suspension to all the test wells of the card by creating vacuum, followed by a positive pressure. Once the transfer is completed, the system will indicate to transfer the cassette by blinking a light. Then, manually transfer the cassette from filling station to the incubation chamber. In this chamber, the inoculated cards are passed by a mechanism which cuts off the transfer tube and seals the card before it is loaded into the carousel incubator. The carousel incubator can accommodate up to 60 cards. For every 15 minutes, each card will come out of the incubator and measured for color development or turbidity by an optical system. The optical system allows interpretation of test reactions using different wavelengths. The test reactions are then compared to the database of the system to determine a close value. The database of the system is constructed with large number of microorganisms. The identification levels may differ based on the recognition of the test microorganism against the database. In the case of low discrimination identifications, two or three possible choices are listed in the order. This occurs when the biopattern is the same for the species listed. However, all species appearing in a low discrimination identification are choices and can be ruled out after additional testing. The laboratory report contains the recommended supplemental tests that allow for differentiation of choices in low discrimination identifications. If the supplemental tests listed are insufficient to complete the identification, then standard microbiology references should be consulted. The Vitek MS is a mass spectrometer, works on matrix-assisted laser desorption ionization time of flight, which is known as MALDI-TOF technology. In this technique, a single isolated colony is spotted onto a stainless steel target slide. Each target slide contains 48 sample spots, divided into three sections. Each section contains 16 spots. Each section is called an acquisition group. Each acquisition group has a small spot at the center, which will be used for calibration. There are different methods for sample preparation for different types of microorganisms. After the sample preparation, the target slide will be loaded into the instrument. The instrument can carry four target slides with 192 sample spots. The microbial culture absorbs the energy from a laser beam and gets ionized. The ionized microbial culture contains differently charged particles with different molecular weight. All these particles fly across a flight tube and reach a detector present at the end of the tube. Particles with low molecular weight move faster than the particles with heavy molecular weight. The detector measures the time of flight for the particles to travel from the source to the detector. The result is displayed in the form of series of electrical peaks. Each peak corresponds to different molecules that were separated from the microbial culture. The spectrum is then compared to the database of the system to determine the microorganism.